Test. Okay, bye. Put it on now, Bob.
Test. There we go.
Testing.
I think we're on now. Hey.
Testing.
We're on now, Dustin. Sorry. We're going to go ahead and start then.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down.
Welcome, Pirate fans. Sorry about the technical difficulties. If you're listening to this for the first time, me, Boston Brent, and your co-host, Double D, Dustin Darnell, number 18 on the football team. Dustin, you excited about doing this broadcast tonight, my man?
Oh, I'm excited. Whenever you ask me, it was a definite yes. I've never done this before.
So we got our starters for the Pirates coming out of here. Who's starting for the Pirates, Dustin?
You got number 21, Carly Estep, number 13, Abby Counter, number 23, Kaylee Darnell, number 22, Ellie Counter, and number 20, Elena Keeney, which is a freshman starting this year.
I'm trying to think who number 15 is for Memphis. I don't have that name and number, so we're just going to say number 15 because I was given a roster about 60 seconds before we came on air, so it's a little tough for me to try to make sure we do play-by-play without knowing these girls' names. But so far, the tip just happened. Memphis Lady Falcons, Berg, Pirates. Three up for Memphis, no good. Rebounded by number 12, Caitlin Puckett. She shoots it off the glass, no good. Gets her offensive rebound. And then rebounded by your sister, KD.
She pushes up the floor.
Right here,
Abby
Counter.
With the shot.
Boom. You're the color man, my man. Ellie Counter with the rebound. Gets the shot blocked. Rebounded by number 22, Maddie Slusher. So far, it looks like the Pirates are trying to push. Double D.
Yeah, the key to this game is we're going to have to keep Memphis off the offensive rebounds just to let it limit the one shot.
Stolen by Kaylee Darnell. Try to set a little two-man game with the big girl inside. Ball's kicked over to Kaylee for three, and no good. Rebounded by Ellie Counter. Ball goes out of bounds, tipped, and it'll stay with the Pirates. I think you're right. I think the up-tempo game favors the Pirates, and they're going to try to go inside to Ashley Blankenship as much as they can.
Yeah.
So out of bounds play, nothing, 7-10, first quarter. Kaylee Darnell inbounds it to Abby Counter in the corner. Back to KD in the corner. She comes off, dribbles off her leg. Ball goes across the timeline, and it'll be an over and back turnover for the Pirates back to the Lady Falcons. So, I was going to talk about a few keys to the game, but I definitely think rebounding is going to be a huge key. They have a definite size advantage. I think Carly Estep's going to have to come up huge against Ashley Blankenship. She's given up, what, you think 10 inches at least?
She's got to have a big game.
Ball's on the right wing to Caitlin Puckett. Try to throw it inside. Stolen away by Abby. They got numbers. Abby looks up the floor to Kaylee Darnell. She goes up strong with the right hand. No good. Rebounded by Ellie Counter. Stolen away by the Falcons. Number 15 coming down the floor.
Break.
Spins. Shoots it off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Kaylee. They got a push right here, Dustin. Up to Abby. Abby over to her sister Ellie, and
foul.
A foul. Two shots. I kind of agree with the Memphis fans right there. I think that was kind of a little bit of a jump ball. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so too, but we'll take it.
Foul told her first team first. Shooting two.
We kind of got a late jump on the broadcast, so we're going to have to load some songs and some tunes up here. Ellie Counter, first basket. Up and good on her free throw, 1-0, 6:32, first quarter. Ellie Counter, second free throw is up and good. 2-0, Pirates. Number 22, Maddie Slusher, bringing it across the timeline. Pressure by Ellie Counter. Over to number 12, Caitlin Puckett. Looking in, getting inside to Blankenship. She didn't even look at her, though. Three ball by number 25. Hannah Toll, no good. Rebounded by Elena Keeney. Freshman here, Dustin. What do you think her role will be this season?
Yeah, she's going to have to come up big. They have some length, or they lack length at least. And, I mean, she's one of the tallest people on the court for the Pirates, so she's going to have to get them rebounds and push up the floor, give it to our point guards.
Abby Counter misses off the back iron, rebounded by number 12, Caitlin Puckett. Puckett across the timeline, ball screen action. She drives in the lane, gets it stripped away. Darnell with the deflection, Keeney with the steal. Pirates coming back this direction, kicks it over to Keeney in the corner, now up to Darnell to the wing. Darnell behind the back, dipsy do, and throws it out of bounds. So it'd be turnover on the Pirates, 2-0, 5:38 first quarter. I think right now first game jitters are kind of showing themselves.
Just, oh, yeah.
We're getting some turnovers, but we're making them on our end too.
Yep, exactly.
It's number 22, Slusher, across the timeline. Again, look, they're going that four out, one in look, trying to get in into Blankenship. And we're surrounding her. We got the look like we got the triangle around her.
Yeah, we always have two people on her. We're going to have one on her and then one as help.
Oh, stole by Keeney. Keeney got it, numbers, drives it. Bobbles it. Ball's on the floor. Looks like it'll be a jump ball. It'll stay with the Pirates. And again, we steal it, turn it over, steal it, turn it over. We just need to steal it and convert.
Exactly. Take advantage of the turnovers.
Ball's inbounded to Ellie Counter. Set a little curl screen for Darnell. Not there. Counter on top. Hits it to her sister, Abby Counter. 2-0. Pirates up 5 minutes. Everybody kind of thinks that these are the two teams to beat in the league.
Yeah, this is the top two teams in the league, I think.
Counter, air ball's the three, rebounded by number 25, Toll. Toll crosses the timeline, gets pressured.
Stolen
away by Keeney, deflected by Ellie Counter. She's got a bunch of deflections so far. Keeney drives it, kicks it over to Abby Counter in the corner for three. No good. Rebounded by Slusher for the Falcons. Submission shots right now, just got to kind of slow down.
Yep.
4:31 first quarter. Pirates up 2-0. Ball screen action again, and we got a body foul on Keeney. You know, some of the other keys I was thinking, you know, you were talking about, we talked about rebounding. I also thought, you know, turning them over would be huge, but it doesn't do us any good if we turn it back over to them.
Exactly. Yeah, but we just got to take advantage, run the offense, slow it down a little bit. I think we're trying to score too fast.
In the words of Boston Brent, you got to take care of the rock. Up to Puckett on the side OB play. She's on the point. Again, look at Carly Eastep working in there. I mean, she is battling. Three ball up from Memphis, no good. Rebounded by Ellie Counter. Up quickly to Irwin. Irwin takes too many steps, but no call. Over to Counter for three.
Good.
That's the way we got to play.
Yep.
Drive and kick. 5-0.
Inside out action.
4 minutes. First quarter. Pirates up 5-0. Slusher across the timeline again. Good pressure by the Pirates. Darnell, she'd get a little tighter right there, though, couldn't she, double D?
Exactly.
I might
talk to her about that one.
Kicks out to Slusher. Slusher looks like the other thing I know is we got a lot more ball handling, that's for sure.
Yeah, for sure.
Over to 15, puts her head down. Ball's deflected but recovered by Slusher. She carried it, but no call. Wow. That foul on your sister? Foul on Ellie Counter.
Yep.
I think she carried it twice before that foul. How about you?
Yeah, I think so too. But the foul came in late and they called that.
Your dad may not like this, but all these officials are from Franklin Furnace. Tied up. Carly Eastep, jump ball. It'll stay with the Falcons. You know, so far, Blankenship's been a non-factor. Carly's in there working.
Yep. That's why it's got to be the whole game.
She's kind of the unsung hero right now. They're double-teaming her on the out-of-bounds play. Trying to keep them from lobbing it. Falcons inbound it. Back to Toll. Toll passes over to number 15. We'll get her name eventually. Now to Puckett. Puckett being pressured by Kaylee Darnell. She spins, travels, but no call. Off the glass and good. Falcons with their first two of the ball game. 5-2, 3-11, first quarter. Pirates up by three. What do you like here? A driving kick action?
Yes, to Abby Counter or Kaylee. You got to think, the whole team can shoot and drive. We just got, like, all-around athletes on this team, you know?
I agree. Ball handling is at its premium.
Yep.
No post play. Darnell for three. And good. KD, drop it like it's hot. 8-2 Pirates, 2:40, first quarter. They get it inside to Puckett, or Blankenship first time. And it looks like Carly Step will get a foul. But I think that's a good foul.
Yeah, so I do
gonna,
too.
He's going to get a layup there.
Yep.
Looks like who's checking in for us for the Pirates here. Got Riley Grant checking in.
Riley Grant.
And Mackenzie Waters checking in for Ashley Blankenship. 2:40, first quarter, 8-2. Pirates up 6. Inbounded back to Toll. Toll being pressured by Abby Counter. Good help and recover. Kick and a three for Slusher. No good. And we got a shove off on Mackenzie Waters. It'll go back to the Pirates. See, the Falcons have another young lady that's about 6'2", too.
Yeah, Allie Correll.
Man, they got a lot of size.
Yeah, very tall. Get the rebounds.
Looks like what's the Pirates in here? Oh, they're going 3-2 zone here. So Falcons going a little flat 3-2 zone. Kind of looks like a 2-3 a little bit, but
yeah.
It's kind of a morphed 2-3. Counter drives baseline, kicks
nice
over
kick.
To her sister, Ellie. She gets hacked, no call. Rebounded by KD. KD wrestles it around. Over back to Abby Counter from deep. And boom! 11-2. I bet we're going to have a timeout here coming up.
Nice possession by Abby Counter.
Here it comes. What did I say, KD? Double D. 11-2. Pirates up 9. 2:05. First quarter, we'll be back. Bird fan.
Always hanging on to the visual. I wanna be invisible. Looking at my ears like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough from the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Ready that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Wheelersburg, BergFan.com back in action. Memphis Falcons with the ball stolen away by Irwin, and she looks like she'll have a double dribble there. I tell you, this BergFan doc here works a lot better when you have it ready before the game. But I had a junior high game I had to go to first. So, Dustin, that's where I'm at in life. 152, 11-2, Pirates up 9. Who's subbing in the ball game?
Carly Stepp. Carly Stepp's subbing in for Riley Grant.
So we got Keeney, Estep, Darnell, counter. Inbounded to on top to Maddie Slusher, being guarded by KD. Ball's thrown out of bounds. That'll be a turnover on the Falcons. Pirate basketball, 1:46 on the clock. Pirates up 11-2 in the first quarter. Right now, I mean, those turnovers that they just keep turning it over. I'd say they have 8 or 9 turnovers already.
Oh, yeah.
And then we turn it over.
Yeah, there we go, too.
Kind of just a lazy pass right there. It's almost like Keeney didn't know what the play was and Counter knew, and she didn't. But, hey, she's a freshman. She'll learn. Ball over to Puckett. Puckett throws it into Maddie Slusher off the glass and good.
Took advantage of the up screen.
Little UCLA action, 11-4, 1:25, first quarter. Counter drives, kicks over to Keeney. Keeney from deep and good. Hey, we got four of those puppies. Four threes, 14-4. Pirates up 10, 1:10 on the clock. Ball's tipped, recovered by Puckett. Puckett over to Slusher. Slusher from deep. No good off the back iron. And it looks like it hit the wire up there, so goes back to the Pirates. Lauren Jolly checking in for your sister, Kaylee Darnell. Hey, if we shoot it this well and we guard this well, we're the league leaders, in my opinion. I don't care about our size.
Yep, I feel the same way.
So a little flex screen looks like it's going to happen here. Oh, my. She's wide open. They missed her. Over to Keeney. 15-footer. No good.
In and out.
Good hustle right there by Eastep, but rebounded by Slusher. 45 seconds, first quarter. Pirates up 10. Schenkweiler drives, kicks over to Puckett. Puckett being double-teamed by Jolly and Counter. Spins in the lane. She might have traveled nice. Seven times. Rebounded by Counter. And up to Abby Counter. Got a chance to really go up big here at the end of this quarter.
Oh.
Jolly just doesn't catch it, and we turn it over again back to the Falcons. I mean, really, that is the only thing that I could say that we could just improve on is just take care of the basketball.
Yep. I think that's what Dusty's going to talk to him about this quarter.
Maddie Slusher on the wing, 15 seconds to go. She picks up her dribble, being pressured by Ellie. Oh, tipped away, but gotten back by Maddie Slusher. 8 seconds. Flipped out of bounds, and it'll stay with the Falcons. 4.7 seconds, first quarter. Pirates up 14-4. I think the same thing. I mean, just a very stagnant offensively Memphis is right now. Not a whole lot of ball movement, a lot of pound on the pavement. So inbounded. A little back screen. No good. Throws it out of bounds. I don't know how the time went off because nobody touched it, Dustin. So maybe I should talk to Gene.
Yeah, I think we should give him a little shout there.
4.5 seconds. 14-4 Pirates, first quarter. In this highly contested SOC matchup. Inbounded to Ellie Counter. 3-2. Over to her sister from deep.
Oh,
off the back iron. No good. And we'll be back in about 60 seconds. BergFan.com. Pirates up 14-4 after the first. Go Bird.
Parenthetical, hypothetical, working out of something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system of catastrophe. And yet a masterpiece, and yet I'm half diseased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die.
Don't act like you're not impressed.
I think the problem with what I just did is I forgot to unmute us. So now we are online. That was my fault. All right, so now it's 19-6. Sorry about that, guys. Blankenship from 15, no good. Rebounded, blocked by Keeney, and fouled, and Puckett will shoot two. Sorry about that, folks. You know, we're going to go through our trials and tribulations because you know who usually runs this is Caskey.
Yeah.
And he didn't hear me make fun of him, so now I'm going to make fun of him again. I think he needs to get in shape. I think his two kids, you know, his kid has kind of caused some issues here and there. But bottom line is he's got to get in the weight room.
Yeah, he does.
He's got to get in the weight room. He's got to get better.
He's got to lift with the football team this year, I think.
So
I don't know if he can handle it.
19-6, Pirates up 13, 5:04, second quarter. Those of you that we lost you, we accidentally lost the service, but we're back. Puckett no good. Rebounded by Grant. Ball's on the ground, though. Picked up by Irwin. Irwin crosses the timeline, gives it to Abby Counter. Counter hits her sister, Ellie, on the left wing. Looking to drive and kick again. Shoots the runner off the glass. No good. Rebounded by KD. KD takes it in. Strong against the big girl, but she blocks it. 19-6. That's a good tough take, though. 4:38, second quarter. Pirates up 19-6. Puckett on top. They're trying to get it inside, but stolen away. Abby in transition. Kaylee just wasn't working, looking for it.
Nope.
Stolen away by the Falcons again. Back up quickly to Blankenship. Grant holding her ground. Good job. Over to Puckett. Puckett backs down Darnell off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Irwin. And slowed up by Ellie Counter.
Yeah, good job.
Coach Carathan said, slow this puppy up.
Yeah, that's exactly what they needed.
Too many turnovers. Over to Abby in the corner. Irwin reverses it around to KD. KD flips it to Counter on top. Counter flips it to Ellie Counter. Ellie spins, drives, kicks. Counter from three. No good. Rebounded by Blankenship. I tell you. Kind of run a little cold here, and I think part of it is fatigue.
Yep.
Got a little tired. 3:42, second quarter, 19-6. Pirates up 13. Looks like Lauren Jolly will get set to check in here. A little shove off there by Shankweiler.
Offensive foul. Number four. Going the other way to the Pirates.
Yes, but I need to push. When I push the mute button on the microphone, does that mean if it's green, is it offline? If it's not green, it's online? If it's blue, it's his microphone. Here, I'll talk right now so you can hear me.
Pass number 15 down to Ashley Blankenship. Stolen by Abby.
We got stolen away by Counter. Ellie drives it, gets fouled, and she will shoot. Is that on the floor? Is that on the floor, Dustin?
Yep.
Okay. Pirate fans, apologize if you're not hearing us. We're trying to get this thing to work. Sometimes.
Yes. All right, thank you.
Pass to Lani Keeney up top. She drives, kicks out to Kaylee. Just a little short.
Rebounded by Memphard. Tell you what, first time Berg fan in basketball, we're just going to screw up and just make it up as we go. Puckett inside to Blankenship. Blankenship shoots the hook shot. Rebounded by Counter. How about Counter guarding Ashley Blankenship inside?
Nice defense. Stay in front. Stay between her and the basket.
19-6 Pirates. Darnell drives. She's got a mismatch, though. Kicks it over to Counter. Counter flips it to Darnell. Darnell from three. No good. Kind of hit a stall here. Haven't scored in a long time.
Nope.
19-6, Pirates up. Rob, the Duke Willard, says, sounds great.
Wide open three by Memphard.
And drains good.
It, takes advantage of it.
Brittany Wolfenbacher hits the three. You know, just kind of lost communication there. 19-9, Pirates up 10. Ellie Counter shoots the runner off the front iron, no good. Rebounded by Blankenship. 2-10, second quarter, Pirates up 19-9. Puckett drives. Goes in strong off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Lauren Jolly. And timeout, Spradlin. All right. Well, we figured out the mic problem. So, Dustin, I'm going to ask you some questions during this timeout. Pirates up 10. Got a full timeout here. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Who's the best lady pirate shooter for the Berg? I need a bag.
Probably Abby Counter. Abby Counter. I don't know.
Abby Counter, best shooter? All right.
From what I've seen so far, I think so.
All right, so here's the next question I have. What does the Berg way mean to you, Dustin?
The Berg way.
Define the Berg way.
What is it?
Define the Berg way.
The Berg way. I mean, if you live up to, like, the Berg expectations, you're in the Berg way. And I just think it's, like, I don't know, like, high class, and you got to have good sportsmanship and everything. I think it's the Berg way.
Integrity.
Respect.
All right, so what did football teach you over the past 4 years?
Oh, my gosh. I mean, it has taught me so much about respect and, like, toughness and battling through injuries and, like, when things don't go your way, just don't quit.
So who on the coaching staff has kind of made the biggest impact on you?
All of them, but if I had to pick one, it would probably be Coach Woodward.
Coach, like, Woodward.
If you need something to talk to, he's always there. And then
more than just a coach.
Yeah, definitely.
It's a good pick. Counter across the timeline to Kaylee Darnell. Pirates up 10, 1:40 on the clock.
Drive by Lainey Keeney, and she makes it for two. 21-9, Pirates.
All right, and then inside to Puckett, and she's pushed and fouled by, I'm not sure who, because there's three people around her. You think that
11,
foul was on?
Lauren Jolly.
So it looks like the next foul on the Pirates will put the Falcons in the bonus. Second quarter, 127. Pirates up 21-9. Inside now to Waters. Waters kicks it out to Puckett. Puckett shoots the 15-footer and good.
Nice shot.
Good rise and finish by Puckett there. 21-11. Counter up quick. Stolen away by Toll. Back this way by Slusher. And off the glass and good. Turn the Pirates over again. Back to Keeney inbounded. 21-13. Pirates up 8. 1 minute. Second quarter before halftime. Over to Counter. Abby inside and gets it stolen away by Toll.
Second steal by Toll.
And back to Puckett. Got a chance to cut it to 6. Kind of total control by the Pirates here until the last couple minutes. Gotten turnover happy.
Yep.
Apple turnover happy. Toll on top. Drives it against Jolly. Goes up strong. Gets fouled, but no call. Rebounded by Abby Counter. Abby pushes. Kicks over to her sister, Ellie. Ellie back to Abby in the corner. Over to KD. He's going to drop the three up in the air and good!
A little momentum.
Don't act
there.
Like you're not impressed.
24-13. Pirates. Kaylee Darnell leading all scorers with 11. Ball up and no good. Rebounded by the Falcons. Offensive rebound, 10 seconds. 9. Waters shoots the three. No good. Offensive rebound again by the Falcons. 8-footer off the glass. No good. Rebounded by Abby Counter. 2. 1. Half-court shot. Ooh. And no good. And that'll end your half. Pirates, 24. Falcons, 13. We'll be back with Double D Darnell, and we're going to talk a little football with you. Wheelersburg. BirdFan.com.
Oh, mama, I'm in fear for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting an end to my running, and I'm so far from my home. Oh, mama, I can hear you a-crying. You're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows, and I don't have very long.
Welcome back, BirdFan.com. Honor the Duke, Rob Willard. Again, we're Pirates up 24-13. We've got about 8 minutes before halftime's over. But we're going to talk a little football with Dustin Darnell. So you mentioned Coach Wilbur and how he's made an impact in your life. You know, you mentioned that he's always there for you. Is there a story that in particular that you can remember maybe going into his office and saying, you know, hey, I need this, or, you know, could you help me with that? Anything that you can remember in particular that, you know, over the last 4 years where he's really kind of built you up into the person you are today? I know your parents have a lot to do with that.
Yeah.
But, you know, your coach has spent a lot of time with you. You know, you go through a lot of ups and downs. So talk a little bit about how your coaches have built you up and gave you the strength to persevere.
I mean, there's a lot of instances. But, like, I remember my, like, sophomore year and junior year, like, beginning of my junior year, like, I would go in and stuff, but, like, maybe I wasn't doing the best and stuff. And, I was playing, like, defense and stuff, but not as much as I planned. But, like, Coach Wilbur could see my frustration. And I think I was just, like, my immaturity. Mm-hmm. And he could tell. And I think he wanted me to, like, mature more, and he, like, knew that. He needed to tell me. So, like, I stayed after practice, and I was, like, leaving, and he got me, and he just told me. He's like, hey, you're going to be in there, and just, like, work at it. So, like, I'd work, and
it's like Rodney Holmes picking up little kids and having them dunk at halftime. But he kind of picked you up and kind of made you think,
yeah,
you know, like, don't quit on yourself,
like,
right?
I was like, yeah, you know what, like, I'm going to work super hard. So, I'll go, like, Pride over by my house and, like, work out and stuff. And, I mean, I think it transitioned to this year big time. Like, I think he finally seen where I've matured. And, I mean, first game, like, he wasn't scared to put me in there. And like, I went from, playing just a little bit, and then from, like, to starting, offense, defense, special teams, everything this year. And I think that's why – and I don't think I would have been able to do it without him, like, you know, like, pushing me towards it and not just coasting and settling for myself.
That's a great story. Now, what's your favorite play that you made this year, like, that you can specifically remember? You're like, man, that play will kind of set my mind for a long time.
Like a play for me?
Yeah, personally.
Okay,
You know how many touchdowns I had in my career?
How many?
Zero. I played golf. So how about you?
Okay. Well, this ain't a touchdown, but it was the first playoff game against West. And
that was the first play of the game, wasn't it?
Yeah, we were decked out in our war jerseys. And the hype, it was like the stadium was unreal. It was packed house. And so, like, I had the jitters and everything. But, like, the game played before West, I could, like, they threw one hitch on me.
Yeah.
So the first play on defense was, like, the first play of the game. I saw Bradford. I saw his eyes look over at me. And I was like, okay. So first
you're like,
play of the game.
A hitch.
Yeah, first play of the game, they, like, did a play action and they threw a hitch. And I jumped it just in time. I made an interception. And when I made an interception, dude, I mean, like.
It was all she wrote.
I could not explain the feeling. Like, looking into the crowd was just going insane. My teammates were picking me up. And it was, like, the best feeling ever.
Now, speaking of your teammates, a lot of them over here at this basketball game. Talk to me a little bit about your teammates.
I mean,
your brothers. I know your mom's trying to distract you right now. But talk to me a little bit about your teammates over there and what they've meant to you over these last, well, since junior high, really.
Oh, yeah. They're waving at me right now. So, hey, guys.
Shout out to Evan Dom. Shout out to Evan Dom. So, no, talk a little bit about your teammates.
I mean, I wouldn't want to spend my senior football anything in class. I wouldn't spend it with anyone else, man. Like, they're the funnest group of people to be around. And, like, it's not just football. It's everything else. Like we'd go do stuff. We'd go to people's houses. And like
Fortnite.
Yeah, we did do that. We set up, like, 10 TVs and play Fortnite. And it was a – I mean, like, everyone's just a blast to hang out with. And I remember, like, we went to – Coach Eaton's house at the end of the year or towards the end of the year, and like we all got together and he cooked the spaghetti before I think it was a Greenview game actually, and he cooked the spaghetti himself, and he's not a bad cook, I'll tell you that.
No, he's terrible. It's terrible. He's terrible brother too.
No, but
try living in the same room with for him with 16 years. It's terrible. It's awful. But you know what, I'm not afraid to say it, he's an idiot sometimes, but he is pretty smart when it comes to football.
Oh,
that's for
yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, but, like, he had us all over, and he cooked the spaghetti, and, I mean, he probably told you about Braveheart. I mean, that's his favorite movie
ever.
I'm
William Wallace. I know. I've heard it a thousand times.
I'm Yonkel. And he is, like, the greatest impersonation of Mel Gibson. But he loves that movie. So we all went over there and ate spaghetti and –
watched a little Braveheart.
Yeah, watched a little Braveheart. And he told – he, like, after the season, and he just contacted us, and he's like, hey, guys – We still got to finish Braveheart, so I think we're getting ready to go back over there and watch the second half.
And that's what it's about, man. That's what it's about. Here's the
more
thing.
Football.
I've always told my coaches in junior high this. At the end of the day, when you're 30 years old, what matters is the experience you had and the relationships that you create. I mean, you know, you're going to win games. You're going to lose games. You know, you're going to win championships and you're going to lose championships. But at the end of the day, when you develop those strong relationships, that's what sports is about.
Yeah, 100%, man. I mean, like, it's just we were so close. We were so close with everyone. Like, no one was distant with each other. And, like, when we go to practice, everyone had a blast. Like, no one dreaded practice. And I don't know. I just think that's what made it so fun. Like, everyone had these good relationships with each other.
Hey, love the shout out. You want to give anybody your teammates a shout out over there? I mean, they're watching. They're kind of pointing at you. Looks like we got Chase Stiddy Stidham over there. Who else we got over there? Tanner Butter Holden,
Dominator Evan Dom.
We got
the kicker Jalen Miller.
We got Jalen the Kangaroo Miller. Got Jarrett Stamper over there. Got Ethan. I'm too goody. We got a lot of people here tonight.
Yep.
We're gonna be back within about a minute and a half, and we're going to talk a little bit of Lady Pirate basketball. So far, Pirates up 24-13. Minute and a half before the second half starts. Enjoy some music. We'll be back. BurkFan.com.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Ready that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
And we're back, Pirate fans. Lady Pirates up 24-13 over rival Memphard. Pirates up 11. And leading in scoring, you might have heard her. Her name's Kaylee Darnell.
Really?
Yeah, she's got 11, leading all scorers. And then Keeney with 7 and Abby Counter with 7. But defensively, we have been a juggernaut. Talk a little bit about the Pirate defense. Suffocating.
I mean, like every person is doing their role, and like I think we're having an intense pressure on them, and I think that's what's making them turn the ball over so much. And also, we're like guarding Ashley Blankenship, which is probably their main scorer. We're guarding her fantastic, limit to one shot, and I think we're taking advantage of the rebounds.
I agree with that. We just need to take care of the rock a little bit better the second half, and we'll be. In really good shape.
Yep.
Just a shout out to my 7th and 8th grade boys basketball team. 7th grade beat Memphard 50-21. 8th grade beat Memphard 40-12.
Nice.
That's the 8th grade's first win over Memphard, actually. They lost 3 times to Memphard last year. 24-13. Keeney, right wing. Started the third quarter. Counter. Drives. Flips it over to Darnell. Darnell flips it over to Ellie Counter. Back to Darnell. Shot fake. Takes it baseline. Good crossover right there. Up on top to Ellie. Back to Darnell. Darnell from deep. Just didn't quite get her hands on that basketball before she caught it. Rebounded by Puckett. Puckett down the floor. A little 4-out-1-in look to Memphard. And again, look at Memphard on the perimeter. Very stagnant. Not much movement.
Nope.
You know, very kind of just stand still and a lot of ball, you know, dribbling the basketball.
Yeah.
Puckett.
That's harder on the ball handler. Like when you have you don't have teammates moving, I mean that's hard to make a move and get by that person without turning it over.
It's a good point. I mean, it doesn't create angles. You know what I mean? You got to have angles to drive the basketball. 7-17, third quarter. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll go back to the Pirates. Up 11 now, 24-13. Ellie Counter drives over to Abby. Abby jabs. Ball screen for Darnell, not to Keeney. You know, gets downhill and gets fouled by Toll. Now, that was the right angle drive. You see the difference? I mean, you
yes.
talk about your dribble drive stuff. That's getting to the drop box right there.
Yep.
For those of you who don't know, Dropbox is about the elbow. Darnell inbounding the basketball to Keeney. Keeney on the left corner in the dead corner. Back up to Ellie Counter. To Keeney.
Ooh, wide open lane.
Just double dribble. So far, again, right out of the gate, Falcons have a turnover and the Pirates have two turnovers. 6:56. Tell me about Evan Dominator Dom. What's he like in the locker room?
He is very, very unique, man. I mean, like, it's probably something you've ever seen. He is he brings energy, and, like, everyone loves being around him in the locker room. It's just totally different. Like, he's in his own little world. Like, you ain't messing with him. You ain't messing with him before games.
Ball scrambled on the floor, tipped away to Matty Slusher. Might have been an over and back call, but no call. To the corner, stolen away by Counter. Counter retrieves it, takes it across the timeline. She's got a 3-on-2 break up to Ellie, to Keeney from deep, and good. Now she got her puppy set.
Oh, yeah.
27-13, Pirates. Coach, I almost said Rob Willard, but the Duke says you do Berg fan proud, double D.
Thank you.
Blankenship, the turnaround, and good. 27-15, Pirates up 12, 5:50. You know, I think a lot of people didn't know how this game was going to be. You know, could the Pirates compete with their size? So far, it's the Falcons that are struggling with our speed.
Yep. Yeah, counter. We're taking advantage of that.
Crossover gets in there, and she'll get fouled. She'll shoot two. You got a crossover like that, Double D?
I don't think it's that good. No, I'm not the greatest ball handler, but.
Don't act like you're not impressed.
Unfortunately, that's the only thing I could get loaded before this game. So we're going to listen to a lot of that soundbite. 5:44. Pirates up 12, 27-15. Counter. Abby shooting two. First one's no good. How about Keeney? Her first varsity basketball game of her entire career. She's got 10.
Yeah, that's nice. I mean, if I had 10 points last year and she got a freshman year, I mean, gosh.
You had 10 points last year. You had games where you had three threes.
But I think she's just, like, not letting the jitters get to her.
She's a pretty relaxed kid.
Yeah.
Puckett gets challenged on their jump shot. No good. Rebounded by Keeney. She's got numbers if she sees it. Up quickly to Darnell, but tipped out of bounds. She's just a little late on that outlet pass. That's where, you know, she'll learn that we got some speed demons. She's got to get her head up.
Oh, yeah.
Ball goes out of bounds. Stays with the Pirates. Little box set here on the under OB. Pirates up 27-15. 5:30 on your clock.
Inbound by Kaylee. Passes the Ellie counter.
Let's see what Ellie's going to do with it. What do you think? She's going to drive and kick?
Drop pass, Kaylee.
Off the glass. Oh. No good. Rebounded by Abby counter. Abby up to Keeney. Back to Abby. Abby doesn't waste any time. Air ball's a three. Ball's rebounded by number 14. I'm trying to remember. Mackenzie Waters. Over. Stolen away by Ellie. Ellie. Weaves in and out. 2-on-1 break. Oh, she turns it over.
My gosh.
Shankweiler just, I mean, really didn't steal it. Lost it.
Yeah. She went to pass it to Kaylee, and then I think she wanted to keep it.
Inside the Blankenship, she gets fouled and will score. So 27-17, she'll have a chance for an and-one. 4:51, third quarter. Pirates up 10. I mean, it's one of those games where you're not comfortable because there's so many turnovers that – you know, just very sloppy. That's
yes,
how I would
very,
describe
very sloppy.
It. I don't think our turnovers are a result necessarily. I mean, I'm going to give them a little credit of their defense, but I think really it's just us playing too fast.
Yeah, I think so too. I think, like, when they turn it over, we just – I mean, we beat them up to court, and we have numbers on them almost every time. And I think we're take advantage of that.
Blankenship makes the AM1. She's a good player. She's got 7 on the night, 27-18. Pirates up 9. This is the dicey situation. Here comes the – blitz traps. Good job by the Pirates getting it out of there. Counter from three. Abby misses it. I'd like to see her shot fake and get it to the rack every now and then.
Yeah,
not just settle for that three. Up quickly to Blankenship. Off the glass and good. And I bet Coach Spradlin might call one here if we don't get a basket. 27-20. Up quickly to Abby. Abby drives. Kicks to Kaylee Darnell for three. No good. Slusher rebounds it. She's got numbers, but she pulls it back out. They've got it inside the Blankenship here lately. Did a good job on the first half, but the third quarter she's kind of showed herself here and made an impact.
There she goes again.
Inside the Blankenship again off the glass and good. And here comes that timeout, like I said. Coach Spradlin's thinking about it. 27-22. Pirates up 5. I kind of told you it was a dicey little situation there. They're going 2-3 and trapping on the wings now.
Yeah, a lot more pressure on our offense.
Leaving Blankenship just in there. Ball's tipped away, but they call a foul on Shunkweiler. Memphis fans don't like it, but we're okay with it.
Yeah, we're okay.
You know, right now they're spreading out that 2-3, Dustin. What do you think they need to do to attack that spread out trapping 2-3 zone? Where's the ball got to go?
I think we need to, like, bring a person on the high post and, throw it across the court and, like, have someone flash high post. And then when they get on high post, I think personally open backside.
The high post is open right now, Dustin, if they look.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It's a little late, right? Looks like the Pirates are running a little two-guard front, just holding it out on top. Content. We're just going to watch the clock run. 3:30, 27-22, and Ellie Counter is counting the laces on the basketball. Now they're going man. They don't want us to hold it. Kaylee Darnell's got the basketball. Hey, good coaching right there. Get it to the high post. Abby counter from three, no good. Ball's rebounded by Ellie counter. She goes up strong and gets fouled. And she'll shoot two. I bet right now Ellie counter is leading us in rebounding.
I know, and she's the smallest girl. And I think that's just like, I mean, that's just work. I mean, she gets herself slithered in there, and I mean, she's
scrapper.
I mean, no one sees her, I guess, and they just go up to get a rebound, and she pops out of nowhere and gets the rebound.
First free throw is good. 28-22 Pirates. 3:08 third quarter. And I think Coach Kasky was just telling Abby Counter, "Hey, shot fake, racket, shot fake, racket," because you know they're challenging her on those threes. You know, she's a mid-range shot just to get herself going a little bit. Second free throw's up and good. Counter, Ellie Counter now. Ellie now has 3 points on the night. 29-22 Pirates up 7. 3:03 third quarter. Puckett crosses the timeline up to Slusher. Slusher drives baseline, kicks it up to Toll. Ball screen from Puckett, looks to roll. Good steal by Irwin. Right now's the chance.
Yep.
We steal it and we turn it over. See what I mean? Just
too
fast. Up to Puckett. Puckett on the left wing going against Irwin. And looks like a shove on Irwin. Ball be taken out underneath. 29-22. Prime example. Great steal. And then throw it back to him.
Yep. No. I think we just need to, I don't know. We get people running lanes. We had one person running lane as Elena Keeney. So we had people back for Memphis, and they just stole the ball.
Slusher from three off the back iron, no good. Rebounded by Toll. Ball's on the floor. Jump Kaylee ball. Darnell gets down and gets it. Be a jump ball. Stay with the Falcons. I think you're right. Plus, the ball handler's got to get the ball in the middle of the floor.
Yeah. Can't throw it across the floor and let Memphis have their running lane to pick off the ball and get it in transition.
So it looks like Toll will take it out of bounds. I guarantee you they're going to cross screen for Blankenship right here. You want to bet $1 million?
That's it.
I might have seen this play a time or two. Oh, no, they just spin. Puckett, left hand, no good. Rebounded by Kaylee Darnell. Now here it is. Keeps it in the middle of the floor. She's pushing. Over to Counter. Counter. Drives baseline. No, kicks it back out to Darnell. Darnell kind of slows it up a little bit. Up on top to Keeney. Going a little four out, one in. Darnell with the pull-up.
Oh.
That looked good, though, didn't it?
It did look good.
Rebounded by Puckett. Puckett will bring it back down. 2:13, Pirates up 7. You know, right now, the Pirates have kind of hit a skid there offensively. Inside now to Blankenship and a foul on Grant.
Ooh.
They were coming to double-team, though, wouldn't they? They weren't going to ever have another one.
Nope.
That'll be the fourth team foul.
First on
Old
Grant.
Team third. Nobody's in foul trouble, that's for sure.
That's a good thing.
Pirates up 7, 2:03 third quarter, 29-22. Puckett guarded by Darnell. Blitz trapped right there off the ball screen inside to Waters. Waters, she travels, but no call. Even Mr. Shaw over there, he was doing the old, that was the travel. Up to Darnell. Darnell goes baseline. A little body foul would be on the floor. Pirates underneath. All right, here's what I run here. I run your sister off a curl cut and just tell her to use that little baby left.
Yeah. She's pretty good with the left.
She is.
That. I think that's what she's better than me at, using her left. I'm not very good at that. Or I'm good, but I don't think it goes her. You know what I'm saying?
So inbounded to Keeney on top. Back to Darnell like we talked about. Will she go?
Goes the opposite way.
She thinks about it, though. She was thinking about driving, shooting a little floater. Good by Abby Counter. Drives it. Shoots the 15-footer. Rebounded by Grant.
Nice.
And fouled. Two free throws. Riley Grant, what'd I say? Take it to the rack. Make him come guard you.
Yep.
Now created an offensive rebounding opportunity for Grant. So 129, 29-22. I'd like to go on a little 4 or 5-0 run here to end this quarter. Grant, first free throw short. Irwin's coming in for the shooter. Looks like a little offense defense.
Yep.
That's Memphis' 16 foul, so their next foul will be going in the bonus. Grant, second free throw.
No good.
Rebounded by Toll. Slusher up quickly. Darnell stops her. Oh, ball's on the floor. She almost stole it. Over to Toll on the right wing. Ball screen from Waters. Toll drives and kicks to the other Waters. It's hard to do, man. Two Waters, two Counters. Slusher over to Brittany Wolfenbacher. Inside to Blankenship. They double her. Ball's tipped out of bounds by Counter, and it'll stay with the Falcons. Great job on help side.
Yeah, Pirates did a really good job of helping the person guarding Blankenship. So whenever they pass it in, we got two people guarding instead of just one.
I mean, I think Carly Eastep hasn't scored a basket, but she's made a huge impact defensively in the paint.
That's the stuff you don't see on the stat book, but
it matters.
Yeah.
She drives. There'll be a foul on the floor by Ellie Counter. I tell you, what I want is a three. I tell you, the next three we make, we're going to go berserk.
Okay, let's see. I'm ready.
I mean, we'll just stand up and start saying something. We yell butter and Dom, butter and Dom,
butter
or something.
And Dom.
Minute to go. Got a grandma on the back that's really upset right now. Falcons inbound it to Blankenship. Throw it right back to Toll.
That's a nice play. That was a really good play. Take advantage of the double team, Blankenship.
29-24. Pirates up five. 50 seconds to go. Looks like the Pirates are running a little five out. Abby drives it, kicks it to Irwin. Irwin, handoff to Counter. 40 seconds. Pirates up five, 29-24. Darnell behind the back, crossover. She's looking to go. Darnell, step back. Ooh, if that would have dropped. That looked like, my gosh, what's his name? Can't even remember. Ball's on the floor, stolen away by Ellie. Abby from deep. Oh, no good. Ball's tipped out of bounds, and it'll go back with the Falcons. 19 seconds, third quarter. Pirates up five. That would look like James Harden.
Yeah,
that's what it looked like.
I think James Harden would have made it, though.
Looks like your sister's cramping a little. Do you have any sympathy for her?
No. Tell her to drink some water, I guess.
Eat a banana.
Actually, I do. I cramped in football. I mean,
it hurts.
Lord, nothing worse.
Pirate little full court pressure stolen away by Abby Counter. And an over and back call. 13 seconds, third quarter. Pirates up five, back to the Falcons. It's like every time we get a steal, we're just not content.
No, we're not.
I guess we really like defense. We want to steal
it. I think so.
We want to give it back to them so we can play more defense.
And then we can steal it again.
13 seconds. Inbounded to Slusher. Now over to Toll, 10 seconds. Guarded by Keeney into Waters. Stripped away by Counter, 5-4. Ellie Counter, 3. Over to Abby, 2-1. The runner off the glass,
short.
No good. And that'll end your third quarter. Pirates, 29. Falcons, 24. We'll be back for the fourth quarter action. BergFan.com. We're back, Dustin. 29-24 Pirates, fourth quarter to go. We got actually outscored that quarter 11-5. We only had 5 points, but, man, we had some opportunities.
Oh, yeah. We took a lot of threes that quarter, but just couldn't capitalize on them.
And, again, the turnover bug. But, you know, your first game, you're going to have turnovers. I don't care who you are and how senior-laden you are, even though we're really not. Really, we got, what, two seniors out there right now? We got Abby Counter as a senior. Carly Eastep's a senior. Then we got Keeney, freshman. Darnell, sophomore. And Little Counter, sophomore.
Yep.
So a little mixture. Ball's inbounded to Ellie Counter on top to Darnell. Just starting this fourth quarter action. This is a huge game because it kind of sets the stage for who's going to win this league.
Yep.
Darnell gets it blocked. Ball. Rebounded by Keeney, and she's shoved by Toll. And that'll be – looks like we're going to be in the bonus. 1-1 for the rest of the game. So Keeney has a chance to score her 12th and possibly 13th point.
Yeah, think about cramping. Kasky just told me mustard. Bishop Watterson game. I think I caught a pass, and I tackled out of bounds. I rolled out of bounds. And
that's what happened?
Yeah, I was like rolled out of bounds. I could not move. Like both my quads were cramping. And Watsy, Dave Watts comes over to me. He has a bottle
of smoke a cigarette in your face? Keeney makes one out of two, rebounded by Ellie and, Counter.
No, it was Blizz. It was Blizz, actually.
He was eating a Debbie cake then.
Yeah, I think it was. He had a bottle of mustard, and never had mustard in my life.
So runner no good by Abby Counter. Offensive rebound out of bounds. It'll go back to the Falcons. Go ahead.
So I had to I was like, I don't want mustard. I'm not drinking it. So, like, they pick me up, and I take one step, and I cramp again. I'm like, screw it. So I take
give me some mustard.
Blizz squirts so much mustard down my mouth.
Did it work?
Yes, it worked, but I spit it. I spit half of it back up on my jersey. I had a yellow Pirates on my white jersey.
Oh, my Lord. I love it. Pirates turn over the Falcons again. They go full court pressure, a little diamond press, and the Falcons turn it over. Now, we got to see if we can convert.
I would love to know the turnover count in this game.
It's a lot.
A lot.
To a lot.
Yes.
That would be my guess. So whatever a lot is, that's how many both teams have. 30-24. Hey, give you something to work on.
Yep.
Looks like they're going 2-3 zone, looking to trap again. Over to Kaylee Darnell, just came in off the bench, shoots a three, no good. And that's what I talked about, fatigue, because every single lengthy jump shot is short.
Shorter, yep. And it wasn't like that at the beginning of the game, but, yeah, I just think they're getting a little – winded there, and just coming up short.
Keeney and Mound to Abby Counter.
They're just going to get legs under their shot. I think they're getting using too much of the arms. And
so KD on top, drives, kicks to Ellie. Counter, left wing, drives, kicks back to Kaylee, to Abby. Ball screen, Abby dribbling along the perimeter, drives it, shoots the scoop.
Nice.
And good. Got downhill.
Yep.
Got downhill. Pirates 32, Falcons 24, 6:30, fourth quarter. Hopefully we can do some interviews after the game. Maybe you can interview your sister.
Oh, okay.
So it looks like on top Waters reverses it to Toll on the right wing, trying to get it inside to Blankenship. I don't think they've done a really good job of really trying to feed her consistently. They've been in and out. Shot up, no good. Ball's on the floor, picked up by Abby, but her foot was out of bounds. So it'll go back to the Falcons. And Rodney Holden, I think he needs, some hair. What do you think?
I mean he has hair around the – I think he has a little circle, though. He has a circle up top of the Baldwin. But,
it's like a perfect dot.
Yeah, exactly. I would like to see him with some hair.
And bounded back to Toll. Toll in the short corner. Decides to dribble back out. Kick it to Slusher. 6 minutes. Fourth quarter. Pirates up eight. And it looks like a – Blotty foul on number 21, Carly Estep.
That's good. Just Carly being physical.
I love it.
Yep.
Coach Holden always says, you got to jam the cutter. You got to jam the cutter, Coach Holden. Got to jam the cutter. I tell you what, you ever been with Rodney to Marshall? He's like a rock star.
Yes, oh, my gosh.
I mean, like the janitors have a cell phone.
I mean, we got to show up to the game 2 hours or 3 hours early because it takes an hour just to walk into the gym because everyone stopped to talk to him.
Another turnover by the Falcons, stolen away by Ellie Counter, up quickly to Keeney, and Keeney just drops it. I mean, had a wide open three, and she just didn't catch it. So, we love defense so much that we're going to go, hey, here's the ball. Here, take it.
I mean,
we love defense.
It's like – Coach Bradley was like, guys, we need three steals before a point.
It's almost like he's like, look, we need more work on our half-court defense.
Yeah.
Half-court main. 32-24, Pirates up 8, 5:40. Fourth quarter. Very sloppy game, but it doesn't matter. Win's a win if we can get it. Slusher drives, gets to Blankenship. Blankenship goes up strong, gets fouled by Ellie Counter. She'll shoot two. And, after this game, so how many catch-rip tuck drills are we going to be doing?
I think I've been here a while.
A little Coach Ader catch rip tuck after this game.
Oh, yeah.
And it looks like all the junior high kids have showed up. I mean, this is a big crowd, man.
This is a very big crowd. Big game.
So far, missed free throw by Blankenship. Blankenship has 11 on the night. She's leading the Falcons, and Puckett has 8. Those are your two leading scorers for the Falcons. Second free throw is up. And good. That's Blankenship's 12th point. Pirates up 32-25.
Oh, my.
And we just throw it out of bounds.
Yep.
And we just literally throw the ball out of bounds with nobody guarding us. Because what do we like to do, Double D?
Defense.
Yeah,
love defense.
That's what we love to do. We're that kind of team.
Yes.
We like putting sand in our teeth. Just grinding on it.
Exactly.
Inside to Blankenship, getting doubled. Might be a three-second call. She goes up strong and finishes.
Good.
Good footwork. Blankenship's 14th point. Pirates now only up 5, 32-27, 5 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Over to Abby Counter, crosses the timeline. Back to her sister Ellie, over to Abby. Abby's got to get one in here. Short. And Blankenship with the rebound.
I don't even know if – have we scored a three in the second half?
We've scored 8 in the second half.
And have we hit a three? I don't think we have.
No, we have not.
Nope.
Free throw line and a couple layups. Looks like a foul on Slusher. And we'll go to the free throw line. And this is where we can make a basket.
Yes.
Because there's no turnovers when you shoot a free throw.
Nope. No one's guarding you. Just you in the basket.
And a shout-out to Harper and Christy Cottle, who's listening in. And Coach Cottle wanted me to give Dustin Darnell a little shout-out. So what are you going to say for Harper and Coach Cottle out there? Thanks for listening.
Yeah, thanks for listening. Go Bird.
Grant, offensive rebound, gets it blocked by Blankenship. Keeney misses the free throw. Pirates up 5. Puckett, do they just leave her?
And then lack of communication. Lack of communication.
And now we got 4:42 to go, and Puckett will shoot 2. 32-27. And Caskey giving Kaylee Darnell some mustard. Oh, that was mustard. You see that? Did you see her face?
That could have been.
That could have been.
I mean, she takes Liz mustard like a champ. Unlike me.
Are you sure it was mustard that he gave you? First free throw, no good.
Oh, yeah. Was
it mustard
Lord.
Seeds?
No, it was a Heinz mustard. No, boy, it was terrible. I'm more of a ketchup type guy.
And well, we got a timeout, and both teams have 4 timeouts. I like the timeout. Fatigue is definitely a factor.
Yes.
All right, so, Dustin, got some questions for you. All right. So far, with 4:42 left in the fourth quarter, who is your player of the game right now for the Pirates? Who do you feel like has kind of showed a little bit of toughness, your unsung hero, if you will?
I mean, I think it's going to be either – Kaylee Darnell or Ellie Counter, because Ellie Counter, I mean, she might not have scored a lot of points, but boy, is she like helping in on defense. I think she's taking the role of last year. You guys all know Ellie Ruby.
Yeah.
Like, no one
like
wanted
the Energizer Bunny.
Yeah,
that's what I call
exactly.
Ellie Ruby.
Always moving her feet and getting rebounds over people much more taller than them and forcing turnovers. I think that's what Ellie's doing.
I'll tell you, for me, you know, hadn't scored a basket, but I think it's made a huge impact. When Carly Estep is not in the game, Blankenship scores.
Yep.
When she's in the game, she has a really difficult time. I think Carly's done a great job. Puckett will shoot a free throw out of here, out of this timeout. I like the timeout because, like I said, I've said this for, like, the last 8 minutes. I think fatigue is huge right now.
Oh, yeah. It's big, and I think that's one of the reasons they keep I mean, we're just not communicating on defense and leaving people open.
Puckett makes the second free throw. Pirates up 4 now. You know, it's trimmed to 4. 32-28. 4:40 to go. Fourth quarter. Keeney throws it off of Toll's hand. It'll stay with the Pirates. Right now, Keeney's kind of got to take care of that rock. But again, you got a freshman, Carly Estep, back in the game for Riley Grant. You know, Keeney scored some points. Just got to take care of the ball a little bit better.
Yeah, and Carly's got to be careful with this. Of course, with 4 fouls.
That's true. Keeney over to Ellie, running a little Ohio. You run that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, counter.
Very familiar.
Puts her head down. Goes to the
nice
baseline.
Pass.
Off to KD. And a good. That's what we talked about in KD.
Oh, there's
uh-oh.
A cramp.
And she's on the ground with a cramp. Well, if you're going to get a cramp, get one after you score. Oh, she's hurt. Ooh, look. Where's Blizz? Where's Blizz, Dustin?
Where's Blizz when you need him?
Yeah, I mean, if she wasn't your sister, I would not be saying this right now, just so you know. But she's your sister, so you're allowed to say these things because you've had to, you know, braid her hair and things like that.
I'm not. I don't braid her hair, and I don't think I don't even have ever dealt with her hair, actually.
How about that drive of Abby?
Oh, that was insane. She drove baseline and people converted on her, and it left Kaylee open backside, and Abby stalled and made a great pass.
And Darnell now with 13 points leading the Pirates. And again, she's got 13. Abby Counter's got 9, and Elena Keeney's got 11. So, I mean, those are your three leading scorers for the Pirates.
Yep.
And Darnell, I tell you, when you get, like, she's got a cramp in her calf right now. When you get that, it is so hard to get rid of it.
Yes, and then, like, you think it's done, and then you go take a step on it again, and you feel it, and you're like, oh, my goodness. And it's, I mean, it's something that.
Can you text Blizz? Tell him to bring some mustard?
I think we need to.
Inbounded to the Falcons. Pirates up 34-28. 4:15, fourth quarter. Over to Schunkweiler. Little ball screen, trying to get it to Blankenship off the roll. Throws it over to Slusher in the right corner. Ball on top to Toll. Toll for three. No good. Rebounded by Irwin. Irwin gets the ball stripped away from her.
Yeah, put it on the floor.
It's a jump ball, and it'll go back to the Falcons. Again, we love defense, so we're just going to get back to it.
Exactly.
I tell you. For us to be up six with as many turnovers we've had tells you how good we are defensively, though.
Yep.
We got a shove.
I don't think it's going to be a very good practice for the Pirates tomorrow. I think it's going to be a lot of
passing and catching.
A lot of passing and offense.
Foul and counter, and that'll put the Falcons to the line. Puckett will shoot a 1-on-1. Both teams have 18 fouls. Looks like your sister's going to bring it back.
Come on, Kaylee.
There you go. Give her a little love. I tell you, are pretty close, though, aren't you?
Yeah, we're pretty close.
I tell you, I remember your dad growing up playing some ball. A little lefty.
Yeah.
Bring it. He could bring it. Franklin Furnace lefty.
I've heard.
Puckett. First free throw, no good. Rebounded by?
Our ball.
Oh, out of bounds. We'll stay with the Pirates. 4 minutes, 34-28. Pirates up six. In this SOC battle for who takes first place right out of the gate. Counter crosses the timeline. Over her sister Abby. Now to Keeney in the corner. Darnell, she's got to watch cutting real hard. Look, I think she might have cramped up a little bit there too. Just pick your spots. Ellie counter over to Keeney. Now up to Ellie again. Ball's on top. Showing some patience here. Kaylee. Hands it off to Ellie. Ball's knocked away, but Ellie gets it back, drives, and gets blocked by Blankenship. And she just makes a cheap foul. That was a frustration foul.
Yeah, exactly.
Puts him to the line to shoot a 1-on-1. Just kind of got her shot blocked and then got mad and slapped at her.
Yep. And, maybe it's fine, but I don't think it's fine this late in the game with the bonus.
And also, how about that was – yeah, what was that, her third or fourth foul? Counters. Can't tell.
Nope, but can't tell.
Came out of the game for Irwin. So Puckett back to the line, shooting 1-on-1. Pirates up six still, 3:24, fourth quarter. Oh, we got a lane foul. I mean, Lord, she went in now there, lit a fire. She, roasted a marshmallow.
She did. She was way early.
So they didn't even shoot the free throw. That was the wildest thing I ever saw.
That was. I've never seen something like it.
She went in there and was like, hey, I'll just hang out here until you guys blow your whistle. Darnell crosses the timeline. Pirates up six. Darnell over to Abby counter. Abby reverses it to Keeney on the left side. Keeney gets fouled, and she will shoot a 1-on-1. Got to make these.
Yep. A very big part of the game.
So far, again, Pirates were up 14-4 at the end of first. They were up 24-13 at halftime. Took an 11-point lead into the locker room. And at the end of the third, Pirates were up 29-24, up five. Now the Pirates are up six with a chance to go up seven, possibly eight, with Keeney at the free throw line shooting a 1-on-1. Keeney, first one's up and good.
Nice.
Cash money. Tickling the twine right there. Pirates up seven now, 35-28, 3:09. Has Butter worked on his free throws?
I think so.
Has he?
Yep.
He's going to be a better free throw shooter this year.
I
love his dunks, but we got to make free throws.
Yep. I mean, he goes to the line, it seems like, 10 times a game at least.
Keeney drops both of them, doesn't even hit the rim. 36-28, that's Keeney's 13th point on the night. Keeney tied for the leading score for the Pirates right now.
Ball's nice steal by Keeney.
Stole by Keeney, and we turn it over because we love defense. And Blankenship gets it inside, and they call a holding foul. So she'll shoot two. You know, there's a song in baseball when you like when someone like throws a wild pitch, you say we love free bases. And I think for us it's we love defense. We love some defense.
I think it is. And viewers out there, if you guys don't know, Boston Brent can sing. If you weren't there for the football pep rally, this guy can sing.
That was that a shocker to you?
That was a shocker.
Hey, you know, you can come to church down at C3. I sing about every 3 or 4 weeks. Just the only church only got 20 people, so nobody hears me. Tell you what, I love playing or you know singing with Coach Wilbur when he plays the guitar. We do it all the time when in the summer kids will come over, roast some marshmallows.
Yep.
And we'll play some guitar. I got videos of him and I doing that over the summer. It's just he's a fun guy to be around. He can't sing a lick, but he tries. But he can play. Blankenship makes the first one. Second one is up and good. And a timeout. Memphard Pirates up 36-30, 2:53 fourth quarter. We'll be back in about 30 seconds. BirdFan.com. Welcome back, Pirate fans, here with Double D, Dustin Darnell, a star corner and wideout. I'm going to call you a flanker for the Pirate football team. Now, Dustin, 2:53 to go. Pirates up 6, 36-30. Shout out to Christy Cottle and Harper. Shout out to the Duke. Shout out to Gene trying to catch up. Shout out to Ocho Cinco, Chad Johnson.
Ocho.
Pirates got to take care of the rock, make free throws. That's going to be a huge down the stretch.
Yep.
Looks like Pirates will be inbounding the ball. Again, just under 3 minutes to go. Fourth quarter, Pirates up 6. Inbounded to Darnell. Full court pressure, 1-2-2.
They're going to go to a press and back into a zone.
Keeney crosses the timeline to counter. Abby dribbles it out of there. Good job taking care of the ball against the pressure. Now, if it stays in Kaylee and Abby's hands, we tend to handle it a little better, you know?
Yep.
Over to Kaylee Darnell on top. Looking around a little clock.
Yeah, we're just wasting time right now.
2:15 on the clock now.
Yeah, I think they can go back. I'd say they can go back into this the blitz trap.
That's what they're trying to do right now, and they fouled Abby Counter trying to trap her, and Abby will shoot too because both teams are in the double bonus. Again, Coach Pradlin going a little offense-defense right here with Irwin. I thought, did the Ellie Counter foul out? I wasn't sure because they took her out awful quick.
I mean, she possibly could have. I wasn't really paying attention to the fouls.
Abby makes the first one. Pirates up 7, 37-30. Make free throws. Take care of the rock. And this game will be Pirates. Pirates will go 1-0 in the conference if we do those two things. Second free throw, nothing but cash.
Is Abby's 11th.
Senior coming through in the clutch. So Abby with 11 now, 38-30. Pirates up 8, 2 minutes to go. Toll for 3, no good. Rebounded by Schunkweiler and good. Just didn't box her out.
Yeah.
38-32, under 2 minutes to go now. Pirates up 6. Over to Abby, is she going to shoot it? Nope,
no.
Smart. Reverses it around. Good job waiting on a good shot. Now 1:45 left. They're not really trying to trap right now. They're not being aggressive.
No.
Pirates up 6. Now under a minute 40 to go.
Yeah, pretty good job wasting time here.
Absolutely. They're going to have to foul her.
Yeah.
Minute 30. I mean, down 6. You got
to
foul.
Trap. Nice ball handling by Elena Keeney. Fouled.
We wasted.
The free throw line.
We wasted right there 38 seconds off the clock. And Abby has a chance to get her 14th and 15th point if she can make – or, excuse me, her 12th and 13th point. So, 38-32, we said it. take care of the ball, make free throws.
Yep. I think we've been, I think we've done a better job this half or this quarter at least of you know, like slowing things down and not forcing passes like we have been the first three quarters.
Missed the first one, so Counter will have a chance to put the Pirates up seven here with this second free throw. It's up and good. Counter now with 12. And again, Pirates pressuring just to kind of give a little token pressure to keep them from getting down the floor so quick.
Yep.
And she nice. Doubled it.
Yep, the pressure got to her.
Double dribble, 39-22. Pirates up 7, minute 18. I mean, I got to think that some people think this is an upset. Don't you think?
I think so. I mean, I think a lot of people expected the reigning SEC champs to come back and get a victory.
And Pirates right now thinking otherwise.
Yep.
Minute 6, Darnell now with the ball. Over to Keeney. Keeney, she might have double dribbled, but they didn't call it. Over to Abby Counter. And timeout.
Timeout.
Coach Spradlin, minute to go. We'll be back in 25 seconds or so. Pirates up 39-32. 1 minute remaining in the fourth quarter. Pirates up 7. BurkFan.com.
Got a girl from the south side. Got braids in her hair. First time I seen her walk by, man, I about fell off my chair. Had to get her number. It took me like 6 weeks. Now me and her go way back, like Cadillac 6. Body like a back road, driving with my eyes closed. I know every curve like the back of my head.
Sing it, Dustin. Let me hear it. Let me hear it.
I'm not a singer. Man.
Come on,
I
Dustin.
Think,
you're
I
in
think,
show
I
choir.
Think.
39-32. Pirates up 7. Minute to go. It's, you know, one thing I will say, Ashley Blankenship is a really good player. She's got 16 points, and she's done a nice job for the Falcons. They just haven't had that second score to really bring them to this win here right now. 55 seconds. Darnell being doubled. She'll get fouled. She'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Double bonus for both teams.
You know, the Pirates have three in double figures. With who we got through double figures? We got Counter with 12, Abby.
And Elena Keeney.
She's got 13, and Darnell's got 13. So this is her chance to get her 14th point. First one's up and short. Yeah, she. You see her legs?
Yeah.
She's like, I don't want to push off this leg. I'm going to get a cramp. Look at Big Steve Sutton over there. Does he not look like a Sharpay?
He does, man.
Like a grizzly bear Sharpay. First and second one short. Rebounded by the Falcons. Puckett being trapped.
Nice
and
steal.
Stolen
by
away
counter.
By Counter.
Bring it back.
Oh my gosh, he just chucked her. And they didn't call a foul. That looked like a block in the back. 38 seconds. Over to Keeney. Keeney to Irwin. Irwin goes too fast, but gets it to Darnell. Darnell to Abby. I'll just say it was a weird way to get there, but it got there. 27 seconds. They're
fouling.
Not fouling.
There we go.
There's the foul. 25 seconds remaining. Pirates up 7, 39-32. Well, hopefully we can get an interview or two here after the game. Usually Coach Pradlin's pretty good about coming up or sending a girl up here. So hopefully we'll interview a lady Pirate or we'll interview Coach Pradlin. Want to bet $1 million. He says that we need to take care of the ball better.
I ain't betting because I know that's what he's going to say.
He's going to say, I liked our defense. I don't like how we pass it and catch it. But you know what? You know, this is a two-time SEC champion. Well, they won it last year. I think Webster won it the year before, I believe. Or maybe it was us. I can't remember. I have a bad memory. But this is a great opportunity to get a one-game lead over a really good team.
Yeah,
and
sure.
Abby Counter makes them both to put the Pirates up 9. And we have a timeout. We'll just go ahead and stay here since there's only about 25 seconds to go. First thing you're going to tell your sister when you get home about cramps is what?
Hydrate. I hardly ever see her drink water around the house, man. And maybe put a couple more extra bottle of water in her backpack.
Some electrolytes.
Yeah.
You know, Dustin, I want to say this, that, you know, you guys had a great four-year career football-wise. I love watching you guys play. I do stats for the team. You know that. I'll post some things on Twitter. You know, the thing I love most about our football guys is I can tell that, and I think even in middle school it starts, we shake your guys' hands and try to make you guys personable. But your coaching staff does a great job of teaching character and integrity. And, you know, you got Sunday breakfast or Friday breakfast at the Methodist Church. I mean, how about this community and how involved they are in these student-athletes' lives?
Yeah, and, like, when you say shaking hands, like,
Little things matter.
Yeah, Saturday breakfast, I mean, we have people at the door when we walk in the church waiting, and we make sure to shake every single one of their hands to thank them for providing us food and the opportunity to give us leadership talk.
It's really a special place, isn't it?
Yes, very.
14 seconds. Memphis trying to run some offense, and we foul her. She will shoot two. It looks like Slusher will shoot two. You know, it's hard for people to understand this. And obviously a lot of people like to pick on Wheelersburg when it comes to social media. But they don't understand. They're honest to God, do not understand what this community is about. You know, I have a lot of friends from Memphis and West and South Webster. And, you know, when I was a kid, I used to go to open gyms at all those places and proms and that whatnot. And, you know, very friendly with a lot of folks in Scioto and Lawrence County. But it's a different animal.
Yep.
And people just don't, from the outside, you know, they just make these comments that are completely false.
Exactly.
Because they have no idea what our community is like.
And prime example is Tanner Wilson, man. That's what he said. Like, he said when he came here, he thought, like, we were a bunch of stereotypical.
Wait. Well, let's end the ball game first. Pirates win 41-35. Blankenship ended up with 18. Great night for her, but the Falcons come up short, and the Lady Pirates go 1-0 in SOC play. But go ahead and finish about Tanner Wilson.
Yeah, Tanner Wilson thought we were a bunch of stereotypical, like, snobby Burke kids, but, like, he told us all, he's like, you guys make it the funnest thing ever. He's like, I wouldn't go anywhere in the world other than Willsburg, and, like, he just loved it, and he's like, I mean, like, if you're from another school, like, all you get told is how, like, Burke kids are snobby and, like, stuck up, but he's like, I came here and I recognized you guys weren't. And
that's right.
He loved it here.
Well, it looks like we might get a player because Coach Spradlin is going to probably come up, or somebody is. So hopefully we'll get somebody. We're going to go on a little 30-second break, and then we'll be back, what looks like, with Tommy Tebow. Tommy's going to make an appearance. So stay with us. 30 seconds. Tommy Tebow is going to have an interview situation.
Take it slow, just as fast as I can. Why she fitting them blue jeans? She don't need no belt. But I can turn them inside out, I don't need no help. Got hips like honey, so thick and so sweet. There ain't no curves like hers on them downtown streets. Body like a back road, driving with my eyes closed. I know.
All right, and we're back, BurkFan.com. Pirates start the season off with a victory, 41-35, and I have my old counterpart, Tommy Tebow.
I'm nervous. I feel like I've never been on here before.
You know, Tommy, the joke of the game was this, that we don't want to play offense because if we hand it to them, we can play defense again. We wanted to work on our quarter-court defense as much as possible, so I think that's why we handed Memphis the ball a lot.
Yeah, that was the plan, you know. So we did want to work on our defense, which our defense was
phenomenal.
Big shout-out, Carly Estep.
We worked all
week on just, you know, taking the fight to their big post player, and she did that. She got on her early. She frustrated her. She outworked her. She boxed her out. She did everything we asked, and, you know, she had a great game, her and Riley both.
You know, and she ended up with 18, but Blankenship did. She's just a really good player.
Yeah.
And, I mean, her size, I mean, she's 10 inches taller than Carly, but when Carly was not in foul trouble, she had a really difficult time getting the basketball.
Oh, yeah, Carly, you know, Carly was able to, you know, get down on her, push her off the spot. And, you know, Carly, I can't speak enough of how well Carly did. Just phenomenal. Yeah, it does seem like 18 was a lot. But
well, you had a couple there at the end,
right.
Some free throws,
but,
some kind of jump points. But it doesn't matter.
Yeah,
like I said, she's an all-conference player.
Yeah, we told Carly, you know, she's good. I mean, she's going to get hers. So just keep fighting, and you know, we're going to fight for four quarters, and we'll let them back off. And that, you know, that's what we did.
Well, how about, you know, Keeney, freshman, 13. You know, I mean, I know she had some turnovers,
yep.
And she had some jittery moments,
yep.
But, you know, still a freshman, first game of her career, coming out with double figures.
Oh, yeah. Well, Elena, you know, Coach and I talk about Elena being just such an X factor, you know, and if she's playing well, I think we're going pretty good. And, you know, we were kind of excited, you know, obviously for the first game, but for Elena, because she, you know, I've only been with them here for a few days, but I've already seen, you know, a little bit of growth out of Elena from her eighth grade year to now, and I think she's now figuring out how good she can be. Obviously, yeah, freshman mistakes on just situational things, and you know, that's just something we're going to have to keep working on, and you know, that's why we, you know, come back each day and try to get better.
So you got Abby Counter with 14, Kaylee Darnell with 13. Both struggled a little bit from the floor, but I thought fatigue was a part of that.
Oh, for sure.
You know, obviously Kaylee cramped up,
yeah.
But, you know, part of it, we talked about it, you know, Abby kept, you know, shooting the long ball, and we were like, hey, if she could just get in the lane and get herself going, and then finally she drove, dumped off to Kaylee, and that
yes.
kind of got the ball rolling
again.
That
was a big moment right there, because I think, what was it, like six or something?
It was five, I think, at the time.
It was like five or six, and that gets it to, you know, seven or eight, so that was a huge possession. That was kind of like their kind of seemed like their last stand. Like they get a stop there, they could be in business.
Actually, we were up four she did that.
Yeah.
Yes, that's correct.
I remember that being just a big basket right there. And you're right. You know, our legs started to fall. We lost our legs. They
yes.
were gone. They weren't falling off. We lost them. But that just attributes to you know, how hard the girls played. I thought we knew that. We knew they'd compete. We knew they'd fight, and that's the kind of group they are, and they did that.
And a couple, you know, one other person I wanted to talk about who didn't score a lot, but I thought probably had eight steals, Ellie Counter, and probably led us in rebounding, to be honest. I don't know the stats per se, but she got a bunch of rebounds.
Oh, yeah, Ellie's so gritty and smart basketball IQ. She was a leader with the ball. But you're right, and she'll just continue to get better offensively. But she is just so fundamentally sound, just everywhere. Just she's very coachable. Anytime you tell her to try something, she goes out there and tries to do it. We've been working box outs like crazy, and you can see that she, you know, was wanting to get in there and not only get the box out but drive back. And you know, she had a phenomenal game.
So here's the one thing I want to tell you. You know, you're now coaching high school girls basketball.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which is your first year doing it. I've talked to a couple girls, you know, I'm not going to mention names, but they are very excited to have you in the gym. I've heard a couple of them. I'm not saying that because you're sitting next to me. I did make fun of your weight a little bit. I think you need to get in the weight room. You need to work out. I mean, I did notice you're getting some love handles. You need to work on that.
I know.
A lot of the girls have said, you know, that they love having you in the gym. What's your response to, you know, being in with the high school girls now, coming from football to now, you know, girls basketball?
Well, I mean, I've been out of basketball for a couple of years, and it's just kind of re-energizing because not only just basketball in general, you know, that I miss coaching basketball. It's like, daggone, you know, I miss coaching basketball, but just this group, you know, just a small time so far that I've been with them. I think during the season, I was only able to get in for about four times. Then obviously, you know, starting Monday, have been back, but
seem like a fun group of kids.
Yeah, you know, very fun. They work hard. They're competitive. They get after it. So it's great. Now, I look at them sometimes, especially Carly. Especially this week, I was trying to get Carly amped up and ready to, you know, fight all night. And then she's looking at me. I was like, you don't know how to take me yet, do you? So I look at a couple of them. They're looking at me like, holy cow, all right.
It's like, what the heck's that play called again that we ran to win the state championship?
The Fat Right Shield Tebow?
Yeah. She's like, what am I supposed to do? You're like, block down.
Yeah.
Block down.
Block down. Throw it to Tanner. Yeah. I catch myself sometimes just, throw it up to Tanner. Oh, wait. Hold on. Okay.
Yeah. He did play girls basketball.
Right.
Well, Coach, we're going to let you know, congratulations on your first victory as an assistant. Coach Spradlin, obviously a great defensive coach, but we have Abby Counter coming on here. So, Coach, thank you for coming over.
Thank
Abby
you.
Counter coming on.
Go Bird.
Abby Counter putting on her headphones and her mic.
Come on, put this on first.
Just hold it there.
Okay, I'll hold it.
That'll work. Just make sure you put it close. So, Abby, you had 14 points on the night. You know, Keeney with 13, Kaylee Darnell with 13, and some unsung heroes that maybe didn't score a lot of points, but Carly Eastep, You did a phenomenal job post defense, and also, you know, just banging, getting in there, and really working hard. And then your sister Ellie Counter, you know, probably had 8 rebounds and 7 or 8 steals. Didn't get in the, you know, probably had 3 points, but did, those two kids did a lot of little things. Mm-hmm. So, you know, what does that say to you when you got unselfish teammates that don't care to get in the scoring column, but they'll go out and do all that dirty work?
I mean, that's just the best kind of team to play for. You don't feel like you have all the pressure on yourself. I mean, if you just set our stats, that's 14, 13, 13, and then those are some even stats. And it's just exciting and fun to know that I can look to Kaylee and she's going to do her job. I can look to Elena, she's going to do her job. Carly's doing her job. My sisters, we're just all coming ready to play. And there's not a moment where you're looking around like, oh, am I the only one still working hard? Because we're all working hard.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, your defense was phenomenal tonight. You held them to 35 points, and you guys probably had 38 turnovers yourself. We, you know, Dustin Darnell and I did the game, and he said, you know, we kind of jokingly said, I think we like defense so much that we're just going to give it back to them so we can play more defense.
Coach Spradlin always says you want to try to wear them out, not wear yourselves out, because we'll sit there forever and just one pass, one shot, miss, and then they take it back. We haven't learned that.
Or steal it and then throw it back to them.
Yeah.
Well, you know, one thing we thought, you know, both, you know, especially towards the end, got very tired in the fourth quarter. A lot of kids looked very tired. But a critical point in the game was we were up 4 points. You had missed a few threes in a row. Kaylee Darnell had missed a few threes. You shot fake, took the baseline, drove the defender, dropped it off to Kaylee. We got up 6, and that kind of was – even though we were only up 6 points, that kind of broke their back a little.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're struggling to shoot it from the three, or maybe you've missed a few, is that your mindset? Try to get it to the rack and try to create a little bit?
Yeah. My dad's always said, if my shots are falling, I got to find different ways to impact the game, whether that's rebounding, being the best passer out there, making sure everyone else is still able to do their job if my shot's not falling. Because, I mean, I have nights like tonight. And so we still got to come out.
It's pretty nice to have a night like tonight. You still ended up leading your team in scoring.
Yeah, but
right?
Yeah, I guess.
Well, you know, the objective of the game, you know, not to quote Dabo Swinney too much, but, you know, is to win the game.
Yeah.
And you just played a team that won the conference last year, went mm-hmm. to regionals.
Yeah.
And you just started off the year beating the defending SOC champion by 6.
It feels pretty good right now.
Absolutely. You know, it didn't happen last year.
No.
So, you know, looking forward, you know, who else do you feel like will be, you know, kind of a contender in the SOC besides, you know, obviously Memphis is going to be a contender, but who else?
Everyone else is pretty athletic this year. Like,
pretty
Oak
even.
Hill is pretty good. Northwest has got a lot of young athletes. I mean, Waverly's going to be competitive. I think we honestly have one of the most competitive SOCs that we've had in a while now.
Spoken like a true coach's daughter. All right, so I know you got to get home, you got to study, you got to get to bed, but anybody you'd like to give a little shout-out to, a little love to?
I mean, my teammates, for one, I love those girls. And then my whole family always comes out and supports. They never miss anything. I mean,
how about Double D doing those broadcasts with me today?
Oh, yes, Dustin, you got to give him a shout-out for that.
Absolutely. Well, listen, Abby, congratulations.
Thank you.
41-35, Pirates lead, and Abby Counter, your leading scorer for the Pirates with 14. Miss Counter, thank you. I'll see you at school tomorrow.
Thank you.
And that'll do it for BirdFan.com. Again, 41-35, Pirates beat the Memphis Lady Falcons in an epic battle. Pirates move to 1-0 on the season and take a lead in the SOC over the returning champs. So, again, congratulations to the Pirates. BirdFan.com. We'll be back with you more than likely for the boys. They play Oak Hill, their first opener, and we'll be back for that game for sure. So, again, BirdFan.com from the Duke, Rob Willard, and Mean Gene. We out.
We're out here in the boondocks with the breeze and the birds. Tangled up in the tall grass with my lips on hers. On the highway to heaven, at the south of a smile. We get there when we get there. Every inch is a mile. Bye.